excited about the next couple of days?
Of course, man. It's a big process coming up. It's Thursday, and it's almost here, so it's ready for containing a smile until Thursday.
What was doing a solo workout like compared to some of the other stuff you've done throughout this process?
I feel like solo workout was just better. More hands-on, more explaining, more teaching you how to do it the right way. Rather than throwing you out there with six other guys and just getting tired and getting through the workout.
How do you feel like the fit went? How do you feel like it goes? Do you think you fit in here?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like they could use a big like me, defensive stopper, athletic, big. So I definitely can see myself fitting in Washington.
What have you made of that kind of shift that the NBA has gone to where the bigs are a little bit more athletic, a little, you know, more defensive focus? Just that kind of suits you well, right?
Yeah, I feel like it suits me well, definitely defensively, because I feel like I can guard all positions, so I feel like that's one of my biggest attributes.
Yeah. Robert, what are you trying to maybe show an NBA team now during this pre-draft process that maybe they might not have seen in college?
Just everything I'm capable of, versatility. Just let them know, let them see a little bit of everything, just showcase all the talents.
Do teams kind of say that they envision you as a 4 or 5? Like, how does that conversation kind of go?
In there's towards a 5 category, definitely. But like I said, that just comes with being open-minded, tackling whatever they throw at you.
Obviously, this team has a really good point guard in John Wall. What do you think it would be like to play with him and maybe run a pick and roll with a guy like that?
Amazing. He's an elite passer, elite guard. Coming off a pick and roll, you have to pay attention to him as well as have to pay attention to me. So it's a win-win situation.
With the way the NBA is changing with a lot of the defensive assignments for big men being able to switch out onto the perimeter, how do you think that your game will be able to translate to the NBA? And do you think that that's one of your strongest attributes as a big man?
Yeah, definitely. Defense, whether it's switching or blocking, I feel like that's my strongest attribute. And it's just about embracing it, you know, wanting to stop a guard, you know, having fun guarding them out there. So I feel like once you're comfortable with it, you can get it.
Did you always have those skills in your tool chest? Like, did you, like, guard perimeter players when you were younger? Or did you play mostly down low? And is this something that you're kind of learning?
No, I guarded all positions when I was younger. Guys way quicker than me. And so when I got to college, I just wanted to improve on that.
What do you think will be the key to you adjusting early on offensively at the next level?
Just learning the spacing on the floor, getting the spacing well, playing with guards, just knowing what they expect of me and knowing how they play.
Are you going to the green room?
Yeah, definitely.
I figured. This year that you can bring like 2 family members on the stage beforehand, do you have that kind of set?
Yeah, most likely gonna be my mom and my sister.
And what would that mean for them to kind of share that moment with you?
I mean, the draft, it don't really mean a lot to them, but they know it mean a lot to me though, so they're gonna be happy.
Is there a, you know, an NBA player that you've watched and you think you could kind of be similar to?
No.
Because a lot of people compare you to Clint Capella, and I know you were in Texas. I was curious, did you ever like watch the Rockets games, watch him, see what he does?
I knew that's what you were going to say, but I watched him, but I mean, he's a great player, you know, but I just feel like everybody's different. You can't compare to him.
You think you could kind of like thrive in the same situation that he does, though, with all
the shooters? Definitely. He around the right people. He just plays his role, you know, he runs hard screens, gets out of there, does what he has to do.
From an offensive standpoint, are you looking forward to being able to operate with a little bit more space?
Definitely. I feel like more space is going to be the key. And just learning how to go at your own pace, you know, once you get the ball.
How many times do you think you've heard the Clint Capella comp in this process?
Like 12, 15.